the shepherd sits up, stands, lights his pipe, and looks around his sleeping comrade. As he looks, he sees something astonishing in his friend.
I must tell you the dreams I have had, for I have dreamt that I could fly.
Oh, wait, wait, says his friend. Wait till I tell you what I have just seen.
No, no, never mind that, says the speaker. Never mind that. Let me tell you about my flight.
It started with a single grain of mud. A wren was looking for work and was taken on by a farmer to thresh barley. And he set to willingly on his work and would thresh one whole grain at a time. But when he threshed the first grain, a mouse came out and pocketed the barley and went away. I thank you not to do that, says the wren. And he threshed another grain, but the mouse came out again and pocketed and was away. Trying my patience. It threshed again, but again the mouse was there. And again the wren spoke. But this time words turned to argument. Argument became blows. Allies were called. Birds of the air, beasts of the land. And so began the battle. Take this, young tempter, take it and listen to what I say. Do not open it until you are in the place you would most love to live. Mark my words, tempter, or it could go badly. The place where you would most love to live. There, safe journey. The family gathered with their friends and their relatives, and feasting was laid upon the tables, and all danced and celebrated the great day, the seventh birthday of young Tethertown. But at noon, two shadows passed across the sky, two hooded crows that circled lower and lower. Away with you, and he threw the poor boy into the moat and turned a third time. Now, Tethertown, now, no more of this. Your promise that day in that wood. More. They agreed. They were entranced. Tethertown slipped away, and at the mouth of the night,